Hello and welcome to MOOC lectures on strategy and introduction to game theory. In this module, we will primarily discuss Stackelberg model. But before we do so, let us talk about market structure and oligopoly. Markets are typically, they are distinguished from other markets using some criteria like the presence of number of firms in the market or how difficult it is to enter in the market or leave the market for a particular firm. Like remember we discussed the entry game, so there we were not modeling it, but typically when a firm tries to enter in the market, it faces several barriers, legal, administrative, financial. So how difficult it is to enter in the market or exit in the market, and it also depends on the ability of firms to differentiate their product. Oligopoly is a special kind of market which is characterized by small number, presence of a small number of firms in the market with relatively high barriers to entry. High barriers to entry ensures that number of firm remains small in the market. And because there are very few firms in the market which compete against each other, each firm faces a downward sloping curve. What does it mean? That if price of their product is higher, demand for their product would go down. It may become zero also if someone is offering the same product at the lower price. You might have seen it in the case of Bertrand competition. So in oligopoly, typically firm sets its price above its marginal cost. Okay? And most importantly for us, as we are studying the game theory, here in oligopoly market, a behavior of a one firm or the action of one firm affects the decision of other firm, because all the firms are typically interested in maximizing their profit. Now what we are going to do, we are going to talk about duopoly briefly. Duopoly is nothing but a special case of oligopoly in which we have only two firms. The basic model that we have been discussing in this course is that there are only two firms and the firms sell identical products. Notice that shouldn't be the case. Even when we have Coke and Pepsi, their products are somewhat similar, but they are not selling exactly same product. But we want to study Coke and Pepsi, we study typically in the case of duopoly market. And also we assume that market lasts only one period. The product or services produced by the firms cannot be stored and sold later. There are two types of duopoly market. One, firms chooses quantities to compete against each other, and I believe that you have already studied Cournot model in that context. And firm sets price to compete against each other, and that's Bertrand model. I think that also you studied earlier. If not, then it's very similar to Cournot model, and only you have to think about that firms are deciding prices as their strategy when they are competing against each other. But there is another model that we are interested in, and that is Stackelberg model. So in Stackelberg model also, firms chooses quantity to compete. What is the difference between Stackelberg model and Cournot model? In Cournot model, both firms make their output decisions simultaneously. Both of the firms choose Q that they are going to produce simultaneously. But in Stackelberg model, firms act sequentially. There is a firm which we will call leader, it sets its output first. Then the other firm, which we can call follower or the rival of the leader, follower is the better word, follower which observes the output decided by firm one and then sets its price. How can we justify it in real life? One can say that leader is a bigger firm and follower is a smaller firm. A smaller firm is a nimble, can wait till larger firm called leader in this case decides its output. But there can be some other reasons also. Right now our interest is in the mathematics of the problem. So once the two quantities are chosen, price is set to clear the market. We have already discussed in the case of oligopoly market, both the firms face downward sloping demand curve. And here, for just for simplicity, we are taking a case where inverse P is equal to A minus B multiplied by QL plus QF, where QL is the quantity decided by leader and QF is the quantity decided by follower. And this is the price that would be present in the market. So what we are basically saying, that here we have price and here we have total quantity. The demand curve is a downward sloping linear curve. How should we solve such game? Again, the technique that we have learned is of backward induction. Work backward, and that's how we are going to solve this. Start at the last step. P is equal to A minus Q, QL plus QF. Now the thing is, the next step before that, follower chooses quantity to maximize given leader's choice. Notice if I denote it in a game tree, this is a situation like this, although this can be really very high. So we can say it's not a line, but a dotted line just to indicate that it is 0 and this is really increasing in this direction. And here is the leader and then follower decides. And here the payoffs gets realized. So here follower is deciding. What follower does? When follower is deciding about quantity to produce, it would take leader's decision as given. Again, notice that we have two different kind of sub games in this game tree. One is the whole game and second sub game in which, second type of sub game in which the follower gets to move. Follower doesn't have any strategic interaction, he just has to decide. So the problem is simpler. How would he decide? He is interested in maximizing his payoff. What would be his payoff? Payoff of firm is equal to the firm's profit, and that is equal to total revenue minus total cost. How much will be the total revenue? The total revenue would be again price multiplied by the quantity it produces. Quantity is its decision, but price gets determined not only because of the quantity this follower is going to produce, but also the price is influenced by the quantity that leader has decided to produce. So what do we have? How much is the revenue? Price A minus B. A and B are arbitrary constant, both are positive. So this is what QF, this is P multiplied by QF. This would be the revenue for the follower. We assume that the cost is linear, so we can say linear cost means higher the quantity follower is producing, higher would be the cost. It would change linearly. So let's say that Q is C multiplied by QF. So this is what's written here. Clear, follower has absolutely no control over QL. What follower can decide? This QF follower has to decide. And how can he decide? Basically, he is interested in maximizing this entity. So simple calculus, if you use, if you differentiate pi F, that is the profit of follower with respect to QF, what do you get? You get this equation. If you set it equal to 0, the follower would be able to figure out how much quantity it has to produce. And of course, it depends on the parameters A, B and also C. More importantly, it depends how much leader has decided to produce. Notice, this is the strategy of follower, because it doesn't only give follower's action in one of the instances, but in fact in all the eventualities. It doesn't matter how much quantity firm 1 is willing to produce, given that quantity, this is what form 2 is produce, form 2 should produce. Also, of course, we have to be careful, I am not taking care of it here, but think about it, if form 1 produces really high quantity, in that case we will have to modify this, that price has to be a non-negative number. If this becomes larger than A, in that case we should assume that price is equal to 0, or in that case the response from follower would be, the best response from follower would be to not produce anything when price is equal to 0. Otherwise, this is the best response from the follower. Now, let us go back one step. Leader has to choose the quantity that it would produce to maximize its profit. Now, what will we have? Again, similar equation we should write, pi L, that is the profit of leader. It again depends on how much is the total revenue and total cost. And how much is the total revenue? And how much is the total revenue? Total revenue is equal to price multiplied by quantity. So, price is A minus B QL plus QF multiplied by, this is price multiplied by quantity QL minus total cost. And how much is the total cost? C multiplied by QL. That is what is written here. The issue is very simple. The logic, the game is of common knowledge. All the players know that all the players are rational, and all the players know that all other players are rational. So, leader knows that how follower will respond, okay, and that we have already obtained using backward induction. If QL is a particular given QL, this is the way follower would respond. So, why? Because that is rational for player 2 to do, or that is rational for follower to do, and this is known to leader. So, leader will take it into account. So, this QF will be replaced by the formulation that we have on the earlier page, and that we have put in the different colored ink. So, the equation gets modified. If you simplify the equation, this is what you will obtain. Now, if you look at this equation does not have QF. This A is known, B is known, C is known. So, only variable present in this equation is QL. And what player, the leader has to do? Leader's aim is to maximize pi of L. And how can he maximize? Again, he can take derivative with respect to QL, and he will obtain the first order condition, and he will obtain the QL. So, this is the derivative you get. If you solve it, QL is, it comes out to be A minus C divided by 2B. Once we know the QL, let us go back to the equation for QF star. Once you know the QL, you plug the value of QL here and you will obtain the QF star. And this is what you will get, A minus C 4B divided by 4B. Okay? So, what would be the equilibrium here? Equilibrium would be that player 1 would produce A minus C 2B, and player 2 will use the strategy A minus B QL minus C divided by A minus B QL minus C divided by 2B. Okay? This would be the strategy used by player 2. Notice here I am writing how much player 1 would produce, because that is player 1's strategy. But here I am not writing A minus C by 4B. This is the outcome, not the strategy. So, when we are writing the equilibrium, we have to be careful that we write only strategies for the player and not the outcome. What would be the outcome? That outcome would be that player 1 or the leader would produce A minus C divided by 2B, and player 2 would produce A minus C divided by 4B. What happens? The leader has the advantage. Why? If you compare these two, leader produces more, price would be same for both the firm, so leader would have higher profit. So leader has the advantage. He sets higher quantity and gets a higher profit than the follower. This is often called the first mover advantage. Okay, but don't you think that in all sequential game the first mover would have advantage? There are many situations in which the later mover would have advantage. Like for example, very simple example that we can take is of matching penny, and in this the players are playing this game sequentially. So player 2 knows what player 1 has decided, H or T. Okay, so H or T, and here you have player 1, and after observing player 2 have to move. Here of course player 2 would win because player 2 knows what player 1 has done. So in this case you do not have first mover advantage. Although this is not an interesting game, but I just wanted to tell you so that you don't think that first mover will always have an advantage. How much is the total output? The total output is the output produced by the leader and output produced by the follower, and it comes out to be 3 multiplied by A minus C divided by 4B. If you use the same formulation and if you obtain the Cournot output, this is what you would get. So in Stackelberg model, the output is higher. Why? This is a graph that gives you the Cournot outcome as well as Stackelberg outcome. What happens in the Cournot outcome? In Cournot outcome, both the players decide simultaneously. So the two equations that we solved one after another, what you have to keep in mind that you should solve those two equations simultaneously. In that case, you have two equations in QL and QF, so you should be able to solve. But here you are solving one after another. So player 1 can pick and then player 2 has to take this into account. So in the Stackelberg outcome, as I have already told you, that the leader has advantage, but overall consumers are happier because you have more output in the market, and because of more output you have lower price. Thank you.